就行，随便拿。
Look out are mentioned many places in Srila Prabhupada's purport.
在圣帕巴的要旨当中，有许多地方都提到了母牛。
Prabhupada always stresses to us the importance of this Brahminical culture and cow protection, both very important.
圣帕巴德就很多次强调了有两件事非常重要：婆罗门文化和保护母牛。
So sometimes, you know, we do often get criticized by people that we're talking about simple living and stuff, but we don't show the example ourselves. But when you come here, you can see how devotees are living and how they're depending on the cows and nature.
有许多次人们都批评我们说，你们口口声声的说要简朴的生活，崇高的思想，但是你们却没有做出表率。但是当我们来到这个农场的时候，我们就亲眼看到了这样表率。
We want to show people the example. We have to show them. They have to learn from us the importance of taking care of the cows and living with the cows.
我们要给人们树立一个榜样，要给人们展示出和母牛一起生活、照料母牛的重要性。
Of course, I know in China.It's a very difficult thing for you people to do in China. You know, mostly living in cities, you live in apartments, you don't have any space to keep cows.
当然我知道在中国呢这很难的，因为你们住在大城市，也都住在公寓里，没有地方养母牛。
But gradually you have to think that, you know, we actually need to become more...agrarian, we need to get more away from this urban concept of life and come back more to a natural living in the country.
但是你们逐渐的应该有这样的一个概念，要慢慢的思考怎么应该远离城市的生活，应该有一个农乡村的生活。
So devotees like in the USA and here also in Malaysia, you know, Singeshwar Prabhu himself, you know, he was not brought up on a farm taking care of cows, you know. He pioneered the Krishna consciousness movement. He led the Krishna consciousness movement here in Malaysia for many years.
那我们看到呢，在美国并且在马来西亚，我们这位帕布呢，他是马来西亚的这个项目的先驱。
And what you see, you know, you've only seen Kuala Lumpur, but when you're going up to Penang, you see the big temple which is there, and the Prabhu Singeshwar Prabhu played major roles in the development of this center.
我们已经去了 Kuala Lumpur, 还有我们将要去槟城，而这帕布呢，他都是这两个中心的，他扮演了重要的角色。
But now he's recognizing the need to enter more into this other phase of development of the Krishna consciousness movement, where we're using the land and looking after the cow.
现在呢，帕布又意识到了这个重要性，我们应该更加强调土地和母牛的重要性。
Prabhu Chandra Swami was telling me, he said, what happens today? People use tractors on the fields, and when you bring the tractor, it just compresses the earth. And when the earth is compressed, then the worms cannot be, we can't live there, we can't.Make their home in the earth anymore because the earth is so tight.
Contrast Swami Maharaj 刚才跟我说现在呢，人们在农田里使用拖拉机，而拖拉机呢就会把土地给压实，而土地压实之后呢，这些虫子、昆虫，它们就无法在地下呢构筑它们的巢穴。
And if there's no worms, then it would be very difficult to grow crops, and that's why they use so many.Pesticides and insecticides and different chemicals and things trying to grow produce.
而没有这些虫子蠕虫的话呢，那么他们这个种植庄稼就很困难，所以他们就用了很多杀虫剂。
What we should be doing, we have bulls, and the bulls can be used to plow the fields, and the cows provide the milk.
但是呢，我们有公牛，公牛可以耕田，而我们有母牛，母牛可以产奶。
And not only milk, but you get valuable things like cow urine, cow dung, and everything from the cow is actually just the environment created by the cow makes it the more good.
不仅是有牛奶，还有牛尿、牛粪，仅仅是母牛的存在，它就创造了一个非常有利的环境。
They had a program for some person. They had these prisoners go and work taking care of the cows. There happened to be some cow farm on the land where these prisoners were kept. So they had these very brutal, nasty criminals who were serving prison sentences for a long time. They put them to take care of the cows.And by taking care of the cows, they gradually became gentle. They actually lost all their bad qualities.
就有这样一个项目，有一些被判处终身监禁的这些犯人，因为他们住在牛场附近，他们就让这些犯人来去照料母牛。通过照料母牛呢，这些非常凶残的这些奸犯人呢，慢慢的他们就改变了他们习性，变得温柔温和起来。
So you live with the cows, if you do service for the cows, it's very purifying, it's very helpful for us to develop our consciousness.
如果我们能够和母牛生活在一起，照料母牛，这对于发展、培养我们的知觉非常有益的。
This planet is actually the property of the cows.
这个星球实际上是母牛的星球。
The deity of the earth planet is Mother Bhumi, and Mother Bhumi is in the form of a cow.
而这个地球的神祇呢是 Bhumi, Bhumi 呢就是一头母牛的形象。
So this planet is meant for the cows, and the cows are domestic animal. They need us. They need humans to take care of them, and we need the cow. So there's that interdependence.
母牛呢，因为他们是家畜，他们也需要人类来照顾他们，而我们人类也需要母牛，所以是互相共存的。
So we're trying to show this example to the world. We want people to know the value of the cows. It's very important to try to educate people about this.
所以我们应该教育世人，教育他们，告诉他们要照料母牛跟母牛生活在一起的重要性。
In India, you see all the temples in India, they all have a goshala, they have their own herd of cows.
我们看到在印度，每一所庙都有自己的goshala，他们会养母牛。
We are having temples and no cows, no land. And so it's very important that we should have cows and we should be able to produceSome dairy products which can be given to the deities.
但是有些庙宇呢还没有母牛，所以每一所庙应该有自己的狗沙拉，这样呢就可以产出牛奶来供奉给神像。
So it's a very bold project. Shrimp Tinishwar Prabhu is taking up, and he's managing to develop this project very nicely.
然后帕布呢，他很好的管理的这个农场的项目。
More and more people coming here and becoming aware of the importance of the cows and how we can benefit from the cows.
有越来越多的人都纷纷来到农场，他们都从这个项目当中得到了好处，意识到母牛的重要性。
People living in cities, they've never seen cows. They don't know where milk is coming from. They think milk is something like Coca-Cola.
在大城市的人们，他们都没有机会见到母牛，他们以为牛奶是可口可乐公司生产的。
But Srila Prabhupada said, just by drinking milk, you can develop, you get pious activities.
舍勒帕帕说，仅仅是喝牛奶，一个人就积攒了虔诚活动。
But to get fresh milk, to get milk from the cow, that's a challenge, not so easy.
但是想要从母牛那里获取新鲜的牛奶，这对我们是个挑战，不太容易。
Everything's from the supermarket.
现在呢，人们每一件东西都得从超市来购买。
And it's pasteurized, homogenized, processed, so many different processes. before you get it in your
这个牛奶呢来到我们客户的手中当手中的之前呢已经被工业化了就是杀菌啊等等高温消毒
we're encouraging the devotees we want to encourage the people everywhere let them see that we do care for the cows we take care of the cows ourselves and we encourage other people also to do this to see the example protecting the cows
我们就想要世人看到我们的的确确也是在照料着母牛我们也亲身给他们做示范